The Nebraska Wesleyan University Sports Network, in conjunction with 5City TV and the Great Plains Athletic Conference, presents Prairie Wolves Basketball. Today it's a GPAC matchup featuring the Warriors of Midland Lutheran University and the Nebraska Wesleyan University Prairie Wolves. This game is made possible by Lincoln Electric System. It's your electricity, own it, and Nebraska Wesleyan University. Now let's take you out to Snyder Arena.
It's GPAC Women's Basketball here on the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network as we welcome you to Snyder Arena tonight. Hello, everyone. I'm Jeff Motes along with John Harris. John, tonight, Nebraska Wesleyan playing host to Midland University. Midland, all-time 71-10 versus Nebraska Wesleyan, but it's going to be an uphill battle tonight for these Prairie Wolves.
Yeah, four players in double figures for Midland, and they come in here with all signs saying that they are the team that come in here to win. I mean, but Wesleyan has to play some tough defense today, stop those four guys from getting in double figures, and come out here with a victory.
When you look at Nebraska Wesleyan, they are two wins on the season already. They got two wins. That matches their season total the last couple of years.
Yeah, well, they're led by Felicia Tekulski, and she's their leading scorer, 14 points a game. She's going to have to get it done. Jeff, it's going to have to be a dirty game. Rebounds, loose balls, blocking out, the whole deal to keep them off the board and to get baskets on their own.
When you talk about Felicia Tekulski, too, she just achieved the 1,000-point plateau for her career. Another player to keep an eye on for Nebraska Wesleyan is Courtney Cook. She's got some bloodlines that go all the way back to the 80s here at Nebraska Wesleyan. Her dad was a pretty good basketball player here, too.
Yeah, she has those bloodlines, and those bloodlines say, we got to put the biscuit in the basket, and she can do it.
We'll see what happens here tonight here at Snyder Arena. Stay tuned. GPAC Women's Basketball about to tip off. Nebraska Wesleyan and Midland University on the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network.
Hi, I'm Ryan with LES's Save Money, Saving Energy, and I wanted to share a hot tip about keeping warm in the wintertime. Instead of turning up your thermostat, turn on a portable space heater. After all, why heat your whole house when you only want the room you're in to be warm and toasty? Oh, that's too toasty. Don't touch that, Gracie. For more energy-saving tips like this, visit us at LES.com or do a search for LES Video Vault on YouTube. We'll see you next time.
You should pick Wesleyan because
it's a school that whatever you want to be in life, you can certainly do it.
I wanted a small school, small campus where I could be one-on-one with my professors.
It's just like one big family. Not to mention the kind of education she gets is wonderful.
I didn't find any of the schools. I know Wesleyan was the one that I wanted to come to.
We want you to come join us and be a part of the Prairie Wolf family and be a part of the tradition of success.
Lincoln Electric System is proud to serve the Lincoln area. We can't imagine a better community to work for, so we owe it to our customers and team members to be something even better. That's why we're striving to be the world's best energy company. The kind of people who work for us are the kind of people who will get us there. Reliable people who believe in safety, integrity, and most of all, serving their neighbors. And at LES, the professionals who work here stay here. The reasons are many. You'll get the technology and training you need to succeed and advance. Benefits that allow you to take care of your family's needs and goals. You'll do important work to help create a sustainable energy future for us all. If you are starting your professional journey with LES, you will gain experience in our wide-ranging internship programs. At the end of the day, people stay here, we believe, for a very simple reason. LES is a great place to work, to build a career, and to do something that matters. It's all because we are local people serving local people.
To Snyder Arena here on the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network with John Harris. I'm Jeff Motes as we get ready to tip things off tonight here at Snyder Arena. GPAC matchup in women's basketball as starting lineups now being introduced for Nebraska Wesleyan. Well, actually for Midland and Nebraska Wesleyan. Let's look at the starters tonight here. The starters look like this for Nebraska Wesleyan. Morgan Nishida will get the start. The 1,000-point career scorer Felicia Tecolste gets the start. Kelly Sanchez also getting the start for the Prairie Wolves. There you see the lineup for Midland. Sammy Licari out of Columbus. Megan Cooks. Joelle Overkamp, another player to keep an eye on tonight. Miranda Paul. Paige Erickson all getting the start tonight. Paul, a junior from Lincoln High. There you see the starting lineups being introduced here for Nebraska Wesleyan. Courtney Cook, Nishida, and then Allie Kalaw, who will get the start tonight. Felicia Tecolste, and it will be Kylie Ashley who will get the start for Nebraska Wesleyan. Kylie Ashley, there you see, along with Courtney Cook. We mentioned the bloodlines for Courtney Cook. And what's interesting for both Courtney and for Kylie, their fathers, Kevin Cook and Lonnie Ashley, played together at Lincoln Northeast with Dana Jansen. All three came over here and played in Nebraska Wesleyan. And you look at the banners here at Snyder Arena, the two of them, 1985 and 86, where they made third place finishes in the NCAA tournament. Between those years, they achieved a state championship at Northeast and, of course, went over here to success at Nebraska Wesleyan. And now the legacy continues with these girls here on the basketball court. But tonight, against Midland Lutheran, who's got a 71-10 advantage all time against the Prairie Wolves, going to be an uphill battle for this Prairie Wolves basketball team.
Yeah, Jeff, as we said in the open, they're going to have to do it dirty. They're going to have to rebound. They're going to get all loose balls, do all the things, the small things that help you to win a basketball game.
Tecolste will jump center, but the tip's going to be controlled by Midland Lutheran as Cooks has it over here on the left wing. Here's Paul. Here's Licari driving right of the key, shot on the way on a scoop shot, missing. And Kalaw with a rebound. And now what do we got here? Whistle on the floor.
See if we have a clock issue.
And we might. Now another rule this year, John, this goes for women's basketball at all levels, that there are 10-minute four quarters.
Yeah, that's right. And I haven't actually been a part of a game yet. This is my first where to be able to see that. So it's going to be interesting how that changes the game, if at all. But you can see Wesley, and they get that rebound, Jeff, and they're pushing it down the sideline into the offensive zone.
Nishida out to Ashley. Here is Tecolste in the high wing. Pulls up, tries to dish inside into traffic, and the ball taken away by Midland.
Yeah, got herself stuck there. Made a bad pass. Turnover, Wesley.
Overkamp, another player to keep an eye on for Midland. Here's Paul, picked up by Cook. Now Licari on the far wing. Shot clock down to 10. Kick out to the left wing. Here's Overkamp off the screen. Dish down low. Shot on the way underneath. Missing it. Was Paige Erickson, but she's fouled underneath by Tecolste.
That's a nice look. She a rub off by Overkamp, and then she just takes a look right down the lane. And there it is, wide open, and the foul. And now she'll have to make these two from the line.
Erickson at the free throw line. Free throw is good. She averages close to 8 points a game. She's averaging about 7 rebounds a contest, so she's rather productive underneath the basket. Second free throw, back iron strong, and Cook with a rebound. About a minute into this first quarter. Spin move, baseline, shot on the way off the glass and in. How about that for Felicia Tecolste?
My goodness, what a beautiful move. On the spin, off the glass, first 2 points for Wesley. She knows how to do that. She's done it often.
Prairie Wolves with a 2-1 advantage. Left side, Licari down underneath on the baseline, puts up a shot, and she's fouled.
That's a long first step that she took there. But she didn't put the ball back down again, didn't put her feet back down again.
Kylie Ashley commits the foul. Quickly, two team fouls on Wesleyan here within the minute. First minute and 17 of this game, and the free throw good for Licari.
You don't mind if you're the road team. At the free throw line. That's where you can often steal the game, is from the free throw line. You got to make them. And that's 3 out of 4 right there for Midland.
3-2 advantage now for the Warriors. Here's a three on the way. Off the rim, no good from the left side by Kalaw. Now the rebound here for Midland. Quickly in transition, Overkamp. Licari here in the left corner. Midland trying to work it back to the perimeter, far side. Good defense here from Wesleyan.
Yeah, nice motion offense. cutters cutting through.
Overcamp for a three, missing that one. Cook with a rebound.
Nice strong rebound by Cook.
Quickly in the front court to Colstead attacking the lane. Three on the way from Kalon. She buries it.
Oh, from downtown, way downtown. And Tchaikovsky can do that. She draws so much attention, Jeff, and she can find that open man for the splash.
5-3 advantage now for Wesleyan. Quickly underneath, shot the glass, and then a little head fake that time for Overcamp.
Thought that might have been a bit of shuffling of the feet. Referees didn't see it that way.
And we're tied at five. Nishita with it now, right side of the floor. Here's Kalaw. Cook attacking left of the key, off the glass with it and in.
Yeah, I thought she could use her left hand, but hey, right nonetheless gets it in the basket.
Now Wesleyan back up by two.
I like the aggressiveness there by Cook. Got to be a threat.
Now the ball knocked out of bounds off of Wesleyan. Actually off of Midland. Wesleyan had a hand on it, but it was Miranda Paula trying to rescue the basketball. So it's off of her. It will be Prairie Wolf basketball.
Yeah, a little nonchalant on the pass to the wing there. Tips out of bounds. Wesleyan got to take advantage.
Kelly Sanchez checks in for Wesleyan. Kalaw off the curl, right side Nishita, three on the way. Short, battle for the ball inside, and Erickson comes up with it.
Nice block out.
Right of the key attacking, layup up and in. Basket counts, Cooks with the basket.
Nice crossover move there. Tremendous job. And into the basket, into the player, into the basket. That cross, boom, all the way to the back. Use that off arm, off the glass and in. The hoop and the harm.
Good crossover that time. Free throw good.
Yeah, takes full advantage. I like the shield that she made there just so the Wesleyan player couldn't slap the ball out of her hand.
Prairie Wolves trailing 8-7. Under 7 to go here in the first quarter. Door shut in the high post. Here's Kalaw for a three. Missing it. And the rebound to Midland. Overcamp quickly in transition, going to push it. Goes up, offensive foul, taking the charge.
A little out of control there.
Kelly Sanchez took the charge for the Prairie Wolves.
Yeah, that was kind of a one-on-four, one-on-three move there. She gets it all the way to the rack, but they call charging. And they're right, nice finger roll there. Boy, that was nice.
Looked like she was right in that ring there underneath the hoop. Left wing, down inside, Cook posting up. Turnaround shot, short, tipped out. Nishita gets it back. Wesleyan will reset.
Yeah, right. She didn't leave it short, Jeff. She's going to get another chance.
Cook on the post, left side, off the glass, missing, no good. Battle for the ball, and it's going to be an offensive foul. Courtney Cook going to be called for the foul. That's her first.
Again, like the aggressiveness inside. Powered it in, backed in, backed in, backed in. Just couldn't get it up off the glass. To Colstie. Back in the ball game here.
Bailey Meehan set to check in here on the next dead ball. Closing in on the 6-minute mark here of this first quarter.
Warriors want to set that high screen and rub off of it.
And now Lakari travels with the basketball. He ran into a double team and maybe a triple team down in the post.
Yeah, when you take that dribble off that high post, you got to know what you're going to do. You only have a couple of options. You're either going to go in there and shoot, you're going to go in there and pass. She didn't have her mind made up and turned the ball over.
Sarah Rowe into the game now for Wesleyan. Down in the key, here's an off-balance shot and in for Felicia Tchaikovsky.
Well, she knows how to score the basketball. And that's a steal.
Now almost taken away by Tchaikovsky, but it goes out of bounds.
What a great job there. I like that. She didn't spend too much time celebrating that basket. Got back down to court and almost got a turnover off of the Warrior player.
Here's Lakari. Right side of the floor. Cook with good defense on Paul. Cooks to the basket, misses it. Got it partially blocked by Kylie Ashley, who gets it.
Should have been a foul there. They don't call it. They let it go.
Here's to Colstie. Here's Rowe resetting.
Wesley has to keep moving. Got to keep moving. Can't be still.
Ashley out top.
Look inside.
Cook looking to get the ball. Here's a 15-footer from Tchaikovsky, no good. Offensive board and put back for Kylie Ashley.
There you go. Look what I found. Christmas a little early. Christmas in November for Kylie Ashley. The rebound and put back.
Prairie Wolves up by three at 11-8. Overkamp has the ball taken away by Tucholsky, and now in transition, Erickson going to be called for the foul.
Yeah, Tucholsky with active hands, Jeff. That's what they call active hands. Going to steal it here, and there it is. And now the foul as they were heading in transition. Love the face, love the intensity.
Addie Wetzel will check in.
You can't be a slob and get 1,000 points, man. You gotta know what you're doing. And she does.
Here's to Colstey.
She'll hit it from there.
Three on the way from her. Rims in.
Yeah, she's gonna need a big night, Jeff. And she's already got a good start going here.
Now a 6-point advantage here, 14-8. Attacking the lane. Back right side, Paul with a three. Back iron strong. And to Colstey with another board.
Yeah, another loose ball rebound there.
Down inside, trying to dish it off. Inside, but back out it goes. Here's Rowe, right side to Colstey, trying to look in.
Yeah, got to throw it up high there to that player inside. Get that hand up in the air. Call for it.
To Colstey for a three, and she hits it.
Oh, she's on fire. She is on fire.
She's got 10 of the 17 points already for Wesleyan. And the advantage now at 9.
Yeah, she's going to have to put this team on her back tonight. Wesleyan, the Warriors with a tremendous advantage historically. Don't matter tonight.
Erickson with a drive left of the key. Rims off. Battle for the ball. Knocked out of there to Colsey. Going to pick up another loose rebound.
There you go. Another loose rebound.
She'll go to the other end. Forces up a shot. Misses it. Now Paul with a rebound.
Yes. A little bit out of control here. Advantage, Warriors.
Bounce pass inside. Right of the key. Back out it goes. Cooks for a three, and she knocks it down.
You're out of control there. That gives the other team an opportunity, and they capitalize.
Well, that stops the bleeding for Midland as they get that three ball. Now within six, it's 17-11, closing in on the three-minute mark of this first quarter. Here's a runner off the way, off-balance shot, bouncing through for Tucholsky.
You know what? She's familiar with these rims, Jeff. She knows that she can do that. This is home cooking here for Felicia Tucholsky. You can't get away with that in most places, but she knows this gymnasium and she knows those rims.
Here's Paul. Paul trying to kick it out to Colsey, knocks it out of bounds. Sarah trying to go to Mandy Euchre, who was in the corner trying to go for a three.
Miranda Paul from Lincoln High, a junior.
Well, to Colsey will get a break, and so will Ashley.
She needs a break, I'll tell you. But they're going to have to get it back on this floor soon.
Kalaw and Cook are back in. Here's a three on the way from Cooks. Back iron strong. Ball tipped in the hands of Wetzel. She'll get the board.
Great job by Wesley in not giving up that second chance. All the loose balls, all the rebounds. Nothing additional for the Warriors.
Wetzel back out top. They move it around right side.
Somebody's got to move through the lane.
Shot clock down to 10. Rowe, right side, Kalaw looking in. Into the corner, Cook with five. Cook needing help, trying to dish it off. Ball knocked away, three on the way. Missing no good as the buzzer sounded on the shot clock. But Midland will get it back anyway.
Yeah, bad possession there for Wesleyan. A little confused without Tucholsky out there.
Euchre to Lakari, now to Paul. Euchre through the defense, basket counts, and she's fouled. And Brittany Fett on the Wesleyan bench was looking for a traveling call.
Well, you know, it's interesting, as we've watched this game from this vantage point, they like that left-hand drive. She thought she traveled. They just saw two steps there. And again, they're back at the free throw line for another three-point opportunity.
Well, they had one earlier tonight. Cooks had a three-point play. Free throw misses, though, and Wetzel gets the rebound for Wesleyan. 19-13 Prairie Wolves, minute 30 to go here in the first. Nishida out top. They go Wetzel. Kalaw with it now. Three on the way from her. Back iron or off the iron. No good. Hit the side, it looked like. And now Midland trying to work an offense here against this Wesleyan defense has been pretty tough to beat tonight. Lakari, three on the way, missing. Now down to the hands of Cook.
Yeah, another rebound for Wesleyan. No offensive rebound for Midland.
Sanchez finds Cook. Here's Nishida with 50. Wetzel.
Move that ball diagonally and then get it inside.
Working the dribble now. Back over here to the right side. Kalaw now. Shot clock down to 7. Wetzel to Nishida with 5. Pulls up. 3 on the way from the top. Long. Ball knocked out of there. Now what do we got here? A shot clock violation. As the clock ran out right before Midland got control of the basketball.
Yeah, I don't know why they just don't continue to play. Midland has the ball. They're headed up the floor. But I guess that's, I don't know if that's a rule or not. It may well be. Because you have to stop play. But we're under 30 seconds.
So the shot clocks are off.
So they're just going to continue to play there. Nevertheless, Midland trying to get this last shot of the quarter.
Overcamp. There's Cooks on the wing, dribbling out front. We're down to 10. Lakari on the dribble. Crossover, going underneath, shot on the way, good off the glass. And time will run out here in this first quarter. And Sammy Lakari with her first field goal. Got 4 points of the game and pulls Midland within 4 after one quarter of play here at Snyder Arena. 19-15, Nebraska Wesleyan on top. Second quarter coming up in a moment.
You should pick Wesleyan because
it's a school that whatever you want to be in life, you can certainly do it.
I wanted a small school, small campus where I could be one-on-one with my professors.
It's just like one big family. Not to mention the kind of education she gets is wonderful.
I didn't apply to any of the schools. I know Wesleyan was the one that I wanted to come to.
We want you to come join us and be a part of the Prairie Wolf family and be a part of the tradition of success.
GPAC basketball here on the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network. A couple of Midland fans making the trip down Highway 77 from Fremont tonight. A few fans here for the Prairie Wolves as well.
Looked like she had a scorebook, Jeff. She's keeping score. Make sure
yeah.
There's no shenanigans here.
Well, we're doing the best we can on our end, too. There you see Athletic Director Ira Zeff.
Oh, famous. A man about town.
Of course, Nebraska Wesleyan.
You want loyalty, you want faithfulness, you want professionalism. There he is right there. Only two words other than Jeff Motes. Ira Zeff.
Well, next season.
You got Maddie Simon down here watching her compatriot from Pius.
That'd be Becky Brokaw.
That's right.
Both were on that state championship team last year for the Thunderbolts.
We were there.
Now the ball's been set. Wesleyan taking their time to get set up, and finally, ball's in play. Kylie Ashley. Here's Kalaw. To Colstie. Work it back out to the perimeter. Again, the shot clock down to 10. To Colstie for a 3, and she buries it.
My goodness. She comes off the bench, been sitting there about a minute and a half, folks, and she comes on, take first shot, blam, splash.
15 of the 22 on the board for Wesleyan.
We need some of those Batman symbols. Splash, boom, pow.
So 15 points for Tecolste, 22-15 Prairie Wolves. Lakari for a 3, missing that one, then that ball's going to go out of bounds, and it will be Prairie Wolf basketball.
Nice job by Nishida on the block out, and that's another thing we haven't seen, Jeff. We haven't seen Midland get second chance points. All so valuable when you're on the road, along with free throws. Wesleyan, a tremendous job of rebounding and getting that loose ball.
82nd time these two teams have met. As rivals, as Tecolstie down the boulevard misses the front end of the layup.
She's not afraid, I'll tell you that.
No, she's not.
Well, I imagine she has the green light.
Here's a 3 from Cooks, missing short, and Tecolstie with a rebound. She'll attack the lane. Here's a teardrop floater, missing, no good, and the rebound to Euchre. Paul attacking. Lakari. Now back over to Paul. Euchre attacking, off-balance shot, puts it in.
Another left-handed drive into the lane. And a basket for Midland.
Four for Euchre.
You got to get yourself set so that they can make that move, get your lateral movement. Can't overplay. They've done it plenty of times on that left-handed drive.
Nishida for a three from the left wing, off the iron. And Overkamp with the board. She'll take it in transition. Ball knocked out of her hands, but she last touches. It goes out of bounds.
Yeah, once again, Overkamp with a head of steam. She has to have that that one person break there. She had her mind made up that she was headed to the basket. Nishida gets the hand in there and tips it off of her hands out of bounds.
Now Becky Brokaw from Pius X. We were talking about her a moment ago. She's into the game now for Wesleyan. Spin move by Tucholsky on the right of the key. Rims off that time. Battle for the ball inside, goes out of bounds. And it will stay with the Prairie Wolves.
Well, she's firing it up there. That's three misses right down the row for her after that three, that big splash three coming off the quarter break. Wide open.
Nishida underneath, up and in off the glass.
Beautiful out of bounds play by Wesleyan. Somebody fell asleep on the backside for Midland.
Her first basket. Lead back at seven for Wesleyan.
They're only averaging 3 points a game, maybe close to 4 points a game.
Down inside, layup missing for Cooks, and the rebound to Ashley.
Again, no second chance.
To Cole State, left side, trying to dish off to Brokaw. Ball tipped out, and Nishida tracks it down. Back inside, Brokaw. Travel with the basketball.
Yeah, I'd like to see her get in that lane, and then somebody set themselves up right outside that arc for that diagonal pass. She should be looking for that as she spins into the lane. Right there. Turn to spin. There she is, right there. Ah, don't give it. Travel. So you have to have a sense of what you're going to do when you spin into that lane. You only really have two options. You're either going to pass or you're going to shoot. Or shoot or pass, one or the other.
Well, you know, a couple of years ago, this group of players, you know, very young, inexperienced, but it seems like now they've matured a little more as time has moved along.
As you well know from being a champion, you know, chemistry is everything. Playing together.
Here's a jumper from the left side of the key, missing, no good, and the rebound to Wetzel.
Boy, I like what I'm seeing here from Wesley.
Colsey going to back it out. Sanchez to Rowe on the far wing.
Colsey has to get some help. Somebody else has to be able to help her out here tonight.
Brokaw.
Spin left.
Going to work, turn around the left-hander, short, no good. Good post up.
Boy, it looked beautiful. I thought a little elevation. She has a basket.
Euchre. Down the key, Overkamp. Missing the layup.
You got a little bit off balance there.
Prairie Wolves in control of the ball. Sanchez, Rowe now. To Colstate for another three off the iron, and the rebound, it goes to Cooks. Here comes Midland the other way. Lakari back to Cooks as they move it around the perimeter. Euchre trying to look in. For Midland, they just need to move the ball around to wear down Wesleyan defensively as Lakari drives right to the key and misses a kind of an off-balance layup, and now Sanchez with it in the front court.
A little bit out of control there, just didn't have her feet under her as she went up off the glass.
Entry pass, one dribble, turn around off the glass and in for Wetzel.
That's a Lionel Richie right there, Jeff. That's all night long.
That was a good post up.
That's right.
Probably didn't need to put it to the floor.
No, not at all, and it'd be great if they didn't have to do that. But, you know, that's exactly it. Just look in there. She's got her on her hip. Throw it in there to her and
now
let her put
foul.
It up off the glass. We call that a Lionel Richie. You throw it in there, she's got that all night long.
That was Kaylee Stokey that committed the foul. I failed to mention that we've been calling her Sarah Rowe. It's Kaylee Stokey for Wesleyan. That's number 12. She commits a foul. That's number 2 on her. Now a steal. Here comes Sanchez to the other end. Puts it up and lays it in.
Nice steal. Nice hands in the passing lane. Coach not happy with that. Going to have a little talk.
Now timeout on the floor. With 4:22 to go here in this first half, a quick 30-second timeout. And boy, Wesleyan, you know, they've matched their win total of 2 wins so far this year. That's how many they've had each of the last 2 seasons. As we take a look at the replay on that steal and breakaway layup that time for Kelly Sanchez, a senior from Lincoln Lutheran.
And Coach Gilbert's not happy about it at all. He is tearing into some folks. Okay, no lazy passes. You gave her a free layup just by not being disciplined. And give Sanchez some credit for hands in the passing lane.
Well, the thing about this matchup tonight, both coaches are in their 3rd season at these 2 schools.
Sanchez going for another steal there.
Euchre for a 3. And Cook with a rebound. Sanchez attacking. Here's Cook.
All the way.
To the basket, puts it up and in.
That's a nice aggressive move there. In control, knew exactly what she wanted to do.
Averages about 12 points a game, a little more than 12 points a game. That's Courtney Cook.
Yeah, we're gonna need more, 12 and more.
30-17, our score. Here's Erickson missing a easy layup underneath off the dribble.
Gotta keep moving the ball. She's open there. Give it to her.
Wetzel gets it, facing up, double team, triple team, back out Cook, 3 on the way.
One more swing. Yep, you're taking that around the horn to Sanchez. Sanchez was locked and loaded on that offside. And that's the rhythm jumper you want. Well, I'll tell you what, you swing that ball around.
Midland finding themselves down 13 here in this first half. Team coming in here at 4-3 on the year.
Yeah, they've struggled on the road, Jeff, and struggling yet again here.
15-footer from Paul, misses it. Battle for the ball, Cook finally gets it.
And once again, Nebraska Wesleyan keeps Midland from a second chance point.
Ashley was posting up right there. She was wide open.
And she was there.
Sanchez.
She has to keep working there, Jeff. Got to keep working.
Shot clock down to 6. Cook gets the dribble. Backs her way in, puts up a shot, missing it. New 30, but the rebound going to go to Midland.
Yeah, those rush shots with the clock counting down, not the kind of offense you're looking for.
2:20 here in the first half. Down inside, nice cut to the basket. Turnaround lay-in for Cooks that time.
Yeah, you gotta. Kylie Ashley should have had her head around. Didn't see the ball, Jeff. You gotta see the ball. She cut right past her.
8 points for Cooks here, and the lead down to 11 for Wesleyan with 2 minutes to go. Kalaw for a 3, rattles it home.
Oh boy. From downtown, the high arcer, that we call that the rainmaker, folks.
2nd 3 of the night for her.
Yeah, from the rafters.
33-19 Prairie Wolves.
Got to keep playing this tough defense. Man on man defense. Don't overplay.
Far wing.
Nice shield there.
Entry pass. Erickson double team. Back in the corner they go. Good ball movement. Shot clock down to 7.
Stay there.
Down inside. Shot blocked by Cook. And the shot clock's going to go off and a violation, and it will be Prairie Wolf basketball. That's great defense that time down that court, that part of the court for Wesleyan.
That is, and Kylie Ashley had an opportunity as she hedged out at the free throw line, but she let her go. Stay there, impede her progress. After all that great defense, you don't want to just have a lapse there at the end and give them an easy basket.
Minute 20 to go here in the first half. Taryn Van Slyke out of Pius the 10th. She's a sophomore. Ashley to the basket on the block, missing it. Ball knocked out of bounds, last touch by Wesleyan.
Again, once again, Wesleyan gets the ball inside. Have to be able to get that ball up off the glass. A bit more control there. Inside a minute here in this half.
14-point advantage for the Prairie Wolves, and this has been a remarkable first half. Now ball taken away by Tucholsky. Back out top, Ashley, three on the way from her off the front of the rim, and the rebound to Cooks.
Yeah, that's not the shot they wanted.
Here's Nelson from the left side, shot fake, puts it up, missing everything. What do we got here? Timeout call by Brittany Fett, a 30-second timeout with 25 seconds to go here. And she has to be awfully pleased with how her team is performing here in this first half.
Indeed.
A lot of up-tempo. They're really transitioning well.
Well, the thing I love about it, Jeff, is that Midland has not, we haven't seen any second chance points. All the loose balls, all those rebounds are going to Nebraska Wesleyan. And so that's exactly what you want. You have to keep them off the boards, and you have to get all the loose, all the dirty stuff has to be yours. And so Midland's not getting any second chances, which is critical on the road.
Well, this is the first of four doubleheaders that we'll bring you this season here on the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network. It's going to be all of the immediate local GPAC teams that we'll be covering this season.
Midland is getting some coaching from Lindsay Moore over there, former Husker. She's right in the face of the Midland players.
Now a steal on the other end by Overkamp. Here come the Warriors. Under 10 to play here in the half.
Stop and go.
Cooks with a layup. Nice take to the hoop. Quickly on the other end, Van Slyke with two. He's up a shot, the buzzer misses it, hits the backboard, and that's how the first half ends here at Snyder Arena. And we're through two quarters of play. It's Nebraska Wesleyan 33, Midland 21 on the Nebraska Wesleyan Sports Network.
Hi, I'm Ryan with LES's Save Money, Saving Energy, and I wanted to share a hot tip about keeping warm in the wintertime. Instead of turning up your thermostat, turn on a portable space heater. After all, why heat your whole house when you only want the room you're in to be warm and toasty? Oh, that's too toasty. Don't touch that, Gracie. For more energy-saving tips like this, visit us at LES.com or do a search for LES Video Vault on YouTube. We'll see you next time.